In this video, we want to review the control panel controls as well as the dynamic indicator settings within Track and Trade. I'm doing this demonstration in the Forex version of Track and Trade, but these features are exactly the same whether using Track and Trade stocks, futures, or Forex. The first thing I want you to notice is that the control panel is on the right-hand side of the chart. We can move that control panel over to the left-hand side simply by coming up to the View tab and saying we would like to have that control panel on the left-hand side. By selecting the left-hand side, we then move the control panel over to the left-hand side. Now the control panel has been put on the right-hand side, and we can do that once again just by removing that check mark on the control panel left-hand side, and it puts it back over on the right-hand side. The reason we put it over on the right-hand side by default is because this is generally the working side of the chart where we're getting the new price bars. And to place orders, the drawing location, or the movement of the mouse, is a closer location to the chart by having the controls on the right-hand side. So this is why this is set by default. Another thing I want to draw your attention to is the tabs across the top of the chart. You'll notice that each tab has a symbol as well as words that indicate what each tab does. We can change that and simplify that, and you'll notice that these tabs have rolled over onto two rows. If we'd like to have just the icons and get rid of the labels themselves, again we come over here to the View tab, we slide down to where we have on here where it says Control Tab Description, and we just simply uncheck that. Of course that's set as default with those turned on, but we can turn those off, and you'll notice that it simplifies the tab settings and just has the icons themselves. The next thing I would like to draw your attention to is the indicator window. In the indicator window, you'll notice that we have the indicator drawn, but we have a feature that allows us to look at the indicator being calculated with every new tick that comes across the chart. Now as we come up here, we say View, we slide down to Dynamic Indicator Update, and we flip that on. This comes up with a warning that says the Dynamic Indicator Update allows all visible indicators to be recalculated and redrawn with each market price change instead of once per chart interval. Enabling this option may cause less than optimal performance with too many visible indicators and charts. You can reduce its impact by using the fastest processor and video card available, switching to a single chart mode, reducing the number of indicators that are active, or deleting charts that you're not trying to use or trade on. Do you wish to enable this dynamic indicator update? We're going to go ahead and say yes. And you'll notice that as each new price bar or each new tick comes through, this is the stochastics indicator, and you'll notice that the stochastics indicator will update with every single new tick that comes across the screen. And as that happens, each new tick updates the indicator. Now, again, generally, when we turn that off, the indicator is not calculated till the end of every price bar. When a new price bar is printed, we update the settings for the indicator. But if you would like to see the indicator update every single time with every single new tick, this is a possibility through Track and Trade by turning on that dynamic tracking. Again, it takes a lot of resources, and we recommend that you use it very wisely. And that's just a quick review of the control panel and the dynamic indicator updates within Track and Trade.